Many days, teachers begin their classes with whole group instruction. We'll begin the same way by looking at ways you can use Lightspeed Classroom's powerful controls and tools to manage your students. In this video, we will cover the different views in Lightspeed Classroom: pause browsing, lock screen, send link, and share screen. Let's begin with views. Lightspeed Classroom provides two separate views to choose from to control your class. The first and most popular view is the screen view. This view gives you a large thumbnail view of each of your students' screens and includes the URL to the current website the student is viewing. You can also quickly tell if a student is checked into the class or not based off what group they are in. Students are currently in class if they are in the group under your class name. Available to add means they are not currently in your class, and offline means students are offline. To help you focus only on your students' screens, Lightspeed Classroom provides you with a full screen view as well. Click on the full screen button next to the resize thumbnail slider, and your view will change to remove all components of Classroom from view except for student screens. You can still resize screens in this view. Alternatively, if you would rather not use student screens, you can use list view. In list view, you will not be able to see the student screen, but you will see if your students are checked into class, what they are currently browsing, and what they have viewed the most. Many teachers like list view because they can monitor their students without the distractions of moving screens during instruction time. Lightspeed Classroom also allows you to filter your student list by status, allowing you to quickly see what students are done or need help. Simply click on Filter by Status underneath your class name and select the status you wish to see. Now, let's look at ways you can control your students' devices. As you begin your class, you may want to deliver instruction to your students without them being distracted by their devices. You can use the pause internet toggle to turn on or off a student's access to browsing the internet. Pause browsing to begin your lesson, then back on when you are ready for students to begin using their devices. This is especially beneficial for districts using Classroom on Windows devices because students will still be able to access native applications such as Microsoft Word to take notes, while not being distracted by their web browser. If you simply need to capture student attention briefly, you can use the screen lock feature. This is similar to the pause internet button, but screens will automatically unlock after 5 minutes. A common use case is an elementary teacher using screen lock, along with 1, 2, 3 eyes on me. If you would like to lock screens for all students, click the ellipses at the top right, choose lock screen. If you would like to unlock screens before 5 minutes are up, click the ellipses and select unlock. For your lesson hook, there may be common material you want the entire class to view. This could be an article, a YouTube video, or a specific page on a website. Rather than having to write a URL out on your board, you can use Classroom's Send Link button to have your desired website automatically open in all student browsers. Click the ellipses, choose the Send Link button. Simply type or paste the URL into the box and click Send Link. This link will open as the new active tab for your students. You can manage web rules for the entire class using the Web Rules button. This is found next to your Pause Internet button. See the How to Limit Web Access video to learn more. Finally, in your Managing Students toolkit, you can also share your screen with the entire class. If you have a presentation or another learning aid that you want students to see, you can share your screen. This works like Zoom or Google Meet. Click on the ellipses and choose Share Screen. Verify that you would like your screen to be shared with your class by clicking Start Share. Choose the correct screen and click Share. You're now ready to view screens and control devices of all students. Thank you for joining us.